presents new challenges, which I'm happy to say that I'm able to some kind of way rise, you know, master the challenge and get through. April was a month of anticipation for me. I had put an application in for a staff writer position, work from home gig, writing on something that I wanted to write on, and the editor like sprung me along. And you know, I waited, and then I did get an email from her. She said she had received my packet and she was on her honeymoon, thank you. And she would be in touch, you know, later that week. Well, that week went by. Another week went by. And I'm always a little hesitant about contacting the editor because they can, you know, that can kind of make or break it. You kind of rather kind of tread that water lightly. And I went ahead and sent the email and I said, you know, I'm just writing a follow-up on the status of my editing and writing task. And then I got an email. And this was my response because I waited like 2.5 weeks. And I will say, you know, it would never ever serve the writer well to, you know, go at an editor. We'll burn bridges that you don't even know are there. All connected, like somewhere in the matrix, I'm trying to get there. So, it's titled Rejection Letter Response on 420. And I decided that I was going to write as opposed to letting her have it. Let me just be professional, close out, and then end. So, Rejection Letter Response on 420. Spent hours on a writing editing test. In fact, I gave that bitch my best. A staff writer position for a work from home gig, got national too. Man, I wrote hard, fast, and strong, but after 2 weeks, something was wrong. Editor held my copy. Shit, it's happening again. Received an email today. They were starting to say, blah, 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 blah. See, my black is strong, probably rubbed her wrong. I don't apologize, no. Before contacting me, she reviewed my cred. Why she won't act like she hadn't read? White people, and that's W-H-Y-P-P-I-O. Pushed me hard to submit and grow. Maybe start my own rag. I'm a writer, yo. Imani means faith. Imani is both noun and verb. And it's a tool I use to push through life's surprises. Those hard times and rough patches that produce challenge. When I find myself unsure which way to turn, I'm reminded to stop and breathe. Relinquishing control to the universe, I wait on her answers. Doing so allows me to wrap my head and heart around the best solutions. The biggest lesson my name has provided me has been the gift of learning to trust myself and to understand that the universe will always provide the best answer. I need but ask and slow down long enough to connect. Faith is sustaining. Faith is necessary. To live my life and live it on my terms, faith is necessary. To see beyond the immediate and to know that I'm connected with a higher power that always has my best interest at heart. I need both believe and know. This next one is called Sacred Space. It's actually a physical place, but it's also a place that I was able to find peace when I was going through a very, very difficult time in my life. I say it all the time that if it were not for my Detroit, California sisters, that you know, there's a lot of states in So, you know, I go through this whole thing, this cyclical thing, and this generational thing within my family, and then I look at the communities and how people are still not really dealing with this issue, and my God, you know, we have to. I don't have to say anything about this current administration. You already know what time it is. This is going to be incumbent upon communities and for people to come together. It's just, we got to do it. We got to, anything can happen. And I don't like living like just anything can happen. But anything can happen because you got a clown running the country. So, when I, you know, get on one of those events, I like to talk about sacred space. And so I ask this of you, where do you go to find yourself? How do you get to your center and reconnect when faced with adversity? I find relief in the refuge of sacred space. Shoes off at the door, I enter knowing how find answers in the solace of my private thoughts. She waits patiently in expectation of my arrival and my excruciatingly deep need to exhale. Her color soothing, she takes me in tones of oranges, blues, calmest yellows, and powerful infused purples. Powerful scents of sage and incense. Lovingly remind me to breathe. One, two, three, deep breaths in. Hold, release. Chimes that inspire Buddhist chants offer a soothing being, being, being. It's in the drumbeats of Mother Africa and the images of goddesses framed on colorful soft fabric. They invoke ancestral spirits that speak to me in hushed tones, reminding me that the answers I see are inside, waiting on the right time and the placement of my chi to come forth. From the lights adorning the sacred altar, an altar filled with offerings to those who come before me, to the signs of nature found throughout sacred space. I know I am special, chosen in fact, for greatness, and that soulful peace is making its way back into my core. Find your space for healing. Make a promise to yourself, insist on it. Enter sacred space as needed and watch the universe pour out blessings earmarked just for you. Okay, I have never read this piece before. It's part of a short story called Campus Blues that I think is about 6,000 words in total. Small excerpt that I just submitted to Cosmopolitan Magazine. They're having they're looking for college stories right now, regardless of when you graduated or if you say college tuition and didn't go, TLY. It's $100 and a chance to then write for them on a personal basis. So this is called from Campus Blues, and this excerpt called, Oh No, You Didn't. Hey girl, it was Cookie, the captain from my high school cheer team. We graduated together from Detroit's Mumford High School 2 years earlier in 1982. She attended MSU, and students came from all over Michigan to school year blowout. I attended Eastern, and it made the trek with my guy home.